Hold on a second here. You turn my mistress more down a bit. I'm starting stream. It's Friday. I stream every day. I want to stream, all right? Other people are streaming, but I'm streaming too. Wish I was the only one. You know, if I was the only person streaming right now, you don't have to watch me. You know what I'm saying? So what are we doing? We're updating our Sukhoi Felon, and we already updated the brand new Mitsubishi Zero, which kind of makes me want to take it out again because I want to see if they fix the problem with the weird little thing hanging above people's heads. Now, before we get into that, I want to say hello. We'll just take a break. Mention that supplies of Diet Coke have been fully replenished. Everything is looking good here. Hope you're having a wonderful day. I got a 3-day weekend coming up in front of me. So pretty excited about that. Today will be a pretty much of a regular stream. We're just going to get in an airplane. Probably it's either going to be the Felon or it's going to be the Zero. It's going to be the Zero. And we'll take the one out that had this weird bug. But we're going to fly around Rome in the Mitsubishi Zero. Because that's where we did. So, yep. Nah, I'm not going to raid myself. I don't care. In any case, which I can do because I'm a mod. I'm not going to. You know, it's a specialty thing. What we're doing right here is we're still updating. It's going to be talking for a while. We're getting pretty close. We're updating the Sukhoi, the Felon. So that's, I might as well keep talking. I don't like to play well. You can play well in the background. So what we're going to do, we're going to talk about a couple things. We're going to talk about the stream yesterday. There we go. How you guys doing? We're going to talk about the stream. Thank you so much for the raid. Hey there. Welcome. Hi. Thank you for coming over. I'm excited to see everybody. Oh, my goodness. Get my tie right. Excited to see everybody today. Hope you're having a great Friday. Welcome to my pretty much every day. It's like this stream. We start out. The first half of it is Microsoft Flight Simulator missions. Just fly over somewhere in the world. Oh, it looks like we've completed our installation here. And the second half of every stream is me playing live music on stream, and alternate between guitar and keyboards. And yesterday was keyboards. That would make today guitar day. So I'll be playing this beautiful, this is a preview for you here. This lovely, hold on a second here. This beautiful Telecaster guitar in my swirl pattern there. We'll be giving that boy a workout. I have 16 guitars. Anyway, so we've been requested, first of all, wait a minute, what is this here? Is there more content? Oh, it says all downloads have completed. That's good. So selection starts, and again, it's nighttime in Italy, but we are going to make it daytime because it's much more fun and interesting to fly around during the daytime. Jeez, where is Rome again? Rome is right, kind of central, right? No, sorry. This is Rome. This is Rome. Plenty of stuff to see. There's the Vatican. We're going to be flying around, and we're going to take off right from here as our departure, but not in this DC-3. Just because it's been updated, and it's one of my newest planes. But stick around for a while. We're going to try to get off the ground as soon as possible and take a tour of Rome, Italy. And I'm going to bring up Google Maps. Now, where is my... These are the planes I have, at least currently installed. A lot of them. But I'm looking for my Zero. Okay, wait a minute. It's down here. Of course, it would be further down. M. I think they're kind of... Okay, G. Wait, was it up here? So past couple days, I've had some real problems. Okay, this is the one that had a visual glitch. It's not serious, so if we have it again... Yeah, that's true. It is a sovereign state. All we have is between the green and the navy. Let's try the navy. We're gonna lighten it up a bit with the fuel. We don't need that big of a roll. We're going to take off rather quickly, and then we're going to go down. You can see from here, these little dots represent... points of interest. So we're going to take off and we're going to go south and we're going to follow this river. That's basically our flight plan. There's going to be a lot to see. But first, what we're going to do is we're going to do the magical thing that we can only do in the Vatican, which is we're going to turn night into day. Okay. By the way, cheers, a little Diet Coke. We enjoy our Diet Coke around here every day. That's a pretty typical thing to see happen. Nature's finest brown fluid, as I like to call it. And this is Microsoft Flight Simulator has a lot of downloadable content, and I always like to purchase any kind of vintage World War II or before craft, including the DC-3 we were flying earlier. I also have a large selection of the more modern jet fighters and things like that, and all sorts of planes in between. But the one thing I don't have that a lot of people have are the jetliners, the big planes, the 777s and the Airbuses and things like that. I've never really had a huge hankering to fly. I mean, I have them and I fly them, but I find them kind of boring. And I like to get pretty close to the ground. So one thing that we're going to deal with is probably a little choppiness when we get too close to a lot of different interesting things. All right. Niner. Okay, first thing you can see is it's dark, and that's not pleasant for me. So we're going to magically use the magical slider to change it to some kind of mid to late afternoon flight. That gives us some nice shadows. Let's take a look. Oh, wait, that's too loud. Let me adjust the audio so you can hear me. What are we in here? Let's bring that down to that there. That's better. Let's take a look at the plane. We're on the runway and we're ready to go. This is a vintage World War II aircraft. This was considered one of the most technologically advanced mass-produced airplanes. In the Pacific Theater, the famous Mitsubishi Zero. Wow. And it's a beaut. I mean, I just love it. Okay. And the interior cockpit is beautifully modeled. Now, do we have this on or off? I think it's off now. Yeah, we can start going. We're going to get our ass heading down the runway. We're going to give us some throttle up to about there. We're going to make sure we hit it. Whoop. We're going to head down the runway. When we get up to about here, then we want to head south. So we're going to make a turn because we're heading north. All right, gear up. That's got that spindly gear that comes up. And that is a drop tank. It's not a bomb. And flaps to zero. And this is what it looks like from here. So this is that little river that we wanted to fall around. You can see it kind of goes this way. All right, engine back down so we don't overspeed. But the great thing about these planes is they are very maneuverable. So for what I like to do, which is just follow a geographic feature. Hey Flint, how you doing? Today it's been chosen to visit Rome. I haven't been in a while. It's nighttime there right now, but we've switched it to day. But basically, I don't know. This is one of the major rivers. All these little things up ahead represent some kind of something to see. I don't necessarily know what it is. I'm doing really good. It's the end of the week for me, and we got, so we got some stadiums. You guys know I like to check out the stadiums. We got a 3-day weekend ahead, because Monday is a bank holiday, and I work for a bank, you know. I'm not a banker, but you know. Okay, so this is a Stadium della Farnesina. And something else there. That's cool, but I want to check out this one. This is the Foro Italico, the Italian Forum, which is, you know, that kind of has a lot of meaning, but it's obviously a great place to watch your football. What's over there? There's a sport. Okay, so there's another more sporting stuff here. This is kind of the more modern part. There's like more sporting. I wonder if some of this was like built for the Olympics or something, or some kind of major thing. Okay, we got a nice straight street to go down here. Don't try this at home. What's our speed? Too fast. This is what it looks like from here. And this is some kind of palazzo we're about to smash into. But we won't. I'll try not to at least. Piazza. Okay, this is the point in the thing where we take free samples. Yeah, we get cash. They rain cash on it. That's a good bet. No, they take care of us though. This is the part of the stream where I go over on my other computer to Google Maps. Not that I'm an expert on Rome by any stretch, but Google Maps tends to know these things, and I put it in. So we got the piazza. It's not a pizza. It's a plaza. C-A-V-O-U-R. Rome. Okay, there's a bunch of them, but we're going to pick the one in Rome. Okay, oh, and that means there should be a really major palace. Okay, which way am I heading? That, there. Right there. That bad boy. Excuse me. The Castel San Angelico. Right here, to the right of it. Okay, so we're crossing over the river. There's that, and there should be a star-shaped thing right next to us. Yeah, that thing, that there is the famous St. Angelo, Castle St. Angelo, Museum National, it's all in Italian. This is just one of the many things you're going to be able to check out when you go to Rome. But, you know, I'm too cheap. Look at all these great buildings, though. We got the Pantheon. Ever heard of it? Famous, the Pantheon. Okay, old building. Up ahead, they did some great job modeling all these old buildings. That's for sure. And we are going to appreciate each one of them. What the heck is this bad boy? Sorry, it's not a bad boy. It's a piece of architecture. I keep trying to get my head around that. Look at that, though, from the air. This is all we really do. We run around. I stop every now and then. And what I'm trying to do here is get a nice screenshot going, you know, so that I can, you know, do more starting screens. Look at the top, though. It's got those, hold on a second, people. Where are we? Yep. It's got these chariots. That's nicely done. Some of the artwork on some of these, all right, back in. All right, we got to fly around. I like to do this too much, and then I end up not going anywhere. Okay, now this small structure here, you might have ever heard of. You might have heard of. Some people know of it as the famous Colosseum of Rome. All right, so don't ever say I never took you anywhere, okay? We went to the Colosseum, I believe. I mean, unless it's the fake Colosseum, but it's got to be. Okay, so what do we got? The Pantheon. And then, yeah, the Colosseum. The Colosseo. This is all the famous stuff is. Okay, there's a Colosseum there. Back there's the Pantheon. The Fora Romano and the Trevi Fountain is going to be down that way, I think. But we won't be able to see that from the air, really. But yeah, I mean, you know, this is Rome without having to deal with the crowds or actually having to go. There's another stadium of some kind. Okay, fine. I'm just looking at these little points of interest. There are a bunch over here. But yeah, that's an old city for you. The Basilica San Giovanni. Wow. Hold on. Appreciate that structure. Look at the complexity. Nice. Wait, are you talking to me?
Yeah.
They're talking to me. That's me. All right. So here is commuter rail station, freight, just a train station. I always like that. I like to know where that's going to be. Our Mitsubishi Zero is flying really nicely. Oh, there's another station. Okay, so this is going to be the main station. It's just amazing how much real estate a European city right in the middle needs for train service, you know, because so many people are coming in from all over the country and all over localities on a daily basis. So this is the Stazione Terminal. This is the terminal station, and that's the end of the line for Rome. Wow. Okay. I bet it's busy ass too. So what do we got here? We got the Villa Borghese. We got the Piazza di Siena. Okay. Yeah, it's really struggling to load all these models, but I don't care. We're gonna something down there. Can't really tell. It's like a nice, like a house or something. All right, that's a nice structure there. This is a hill. There's seven hills in Rome. You know, there's one of them right here. I think the Stadio Flaminio. Okay, that's stadium. I wonder if that's for bullfighting. I wonder, because it doesn't look like. Interesting. Oh, and look at this. What the heck's going on here? What the heck's going on here? Look at that. It's got some weird ass looking shaped buildings. The Stadio Flaminio, which I'm kind of wondering is for bullfighting. You're going to find out. And that structure down there with the dome. Okay. You know, I'm into domes. Hey, Giorgio, how you doing? Yeah, Giorgio's cool. He likes to do those airline flights. Okay, what is this stadio again? Can I get the name of this again? Let me see if I can figure it out. I don't know if I can. Okay, where are we? Okay, we're heading north over the city. Right, so I flew around there. So we're kind of this way here. Yeah, I'm not sure if it says what it's for. Okay, let's keep going. We're probably going to turn around, because at the speed we're going here, we've already kind of crossed over. What a nice bridge, though. We've already, most of the city's behind us, and we want to make another tour. Oh, yeah, okay, we started around here, so the airport's right over here. The airport that we took off is right there. All right, yeah. We got plenty of fuel, though. One of the things I like to check, though, I was reading about this, or checked this up earlier, is, are we using the external tank? No, we're using the main tank. How can we switch to the external tank? Because when the external tank gets to zero, it, is it here? Tailwheel lock. Where would the fuel be? I think it's here. Fuel lev off. Fuel selector. Main, external. It should have been all. Okay, the Stadio Flaminio. That's what I was thinking of. Hold on a second. Stadio Flaminio. What is that? Yeah, that's it. What does it say about it? I'm just curious what it says. Here in Google. Save the stadium. Well, it's abandoned, and they don't use it anymore, according to Google. There you go. Yeah, support his dream, I guess. 3 kilometers northwest of the city center, unique works. So, no, they don't use it there. And that little dome above it, though, is a Palazzo della Sport. What did they play in there? It's arena, precast columns. It's a shame that the roof is not open. It doesn't say what sport they play there. Small sport palace in the arena for the Olympics. Basketball. Thank you, finally. That's going to be like 500. This little dome thing there. You can play basketball in there. Wondering how big the thing is. So there's a national museum there. Okay, but then the rest of the city is south. So yeah, I've never been to Rome, and I may never, but you get the feeling of just like a huge, pretty spread out city, and also fairly inland. I mean, the ocean's a long way, I think, to the west, this way. Okay, so there's the Trevi Fountain, the famous fountain. You can't really see it there because it's surrounded by buildings. Let's see how good they did with the model. We're going to pop off the plane for a second and make a little the journey to the Trevi Fountain, which is down here. I just want to check out how elaborate their Trevi Fountain, elaborate, you know what I mean? You can fly right down, and you can see it's surrounded by buildings, so you're not going to see it very well unless you're in a helicopter. I mean, it's not perfect, but I guess from about here, it looks great. All right, where's our plane? back in. All right, pop back in. All right, let's get going. Can't stay not flying for too long. Right, so we checked that piece. Oh, right, there's something down here. Something down. Okay, this is a special bridge. Ponte Garibaldi. Okay. Okay, that's what they call bridges, pontes, I'm guessing. And this is the Terrazza Gianicolo. Gianicolo. It looks like just a nice place to go. You park there, there's a little thing, and then you can look out over the city. So it's on top of one of the seven hills. Okay, nice. We like it. Oh, and then this item here, the Basilica of St. Peter's. St. Peter's Basilica. The famous, probably the most famous basilica, which is like a super cathedral. Or a domed cathedral. Oh, so is this where, wait a minute. So where exactly, this is the Vatican. That's the Vatican City right here. We are flying over the Vatican. You can tell because that's that square, that central area there, is pretty iconic. Yeah, I'm like, oh, which it's pretty famous. It's technically not in Rome. It's in the Vatican, which is where. Where's the Vatican? I mean, we're there, but I just want to look on the map here. City. Okay. Yes, exactly. It's the famous obelisk of St. Peter's Square, the Basilica of Rome. Yeah. So this area that we're kind of looking at here where that greenery is, and just down through that street there and there, that's Vatican City. It's not huge. And this part here, I believe. This part of Vatican. No, that part is not part in Vatican City, I think. I take it back. Just that greenery. No, see where that is not. This little area here is not. So that green area back there, it comes down here. These buildings are not. And then it comes right down that road there and comes to the front. Oh, no, it doesn't include any of these buildings. This actually, this gate here is the front of the Vatican, where that is. And then it goes to the back. God, it's tiny. That is small. But don't tell anyone I didn't take you to see the Pope. He's there. He's just hiding. He's going, why is there a Japanese warplane flying above me? They're like, Papa, relax, it'll be fine. Papa. I don't know what to say. But we got to get even lower and faster, I think, because I'm starting to get bored. Well. Okay, we flew over that piazza. There's this area here. There's this stuff to see over here. We're not doing too bad on the frame rate, considering what it's chomping down on. It's got a few glitches, but we did download a driver that's supposed to improve things, and I did clear my 3D shader crash. See, right as soon as I talk about glitches. But we're low, which is where the glitches happen. And this up here, again, this is the train station up here, right? This is the terminal, the terminus, the end of the line train station. It's probably cool. That's all an indoor area there, I'm guessing, or partially indoor. What do the outskirts look like? We'll fly around a little bit more in the outer loop. It's like there's another kind of, what, sporting event? No. I don't know what that is. Maybe that's a train, that's a train yard. That's a locomotive house where they put the locomotives. They're like, they always look like that. There's another cool looking train station. A little more out of the way. And as we travel more to the east and southeast, it's gonna get a lot more suburban, I think. Behind us, that's where the city would be. So we're only about like a few miles away. Well, yeah, Rome. Can't beat it for being Rome. And all I gotta say is, let's see, is it still there? there still is the little glitch. Now, what does it look like to you guys? I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but it looks like there's a little dot right now flying in the blue sky above my plane. I was wondering, did they fix that? Because I just had a download today of this airplane, an update to the airplane. I'm like, well, they must have fixed it. Now, if you look as I turn, it moves. It stays in a specific spot above my plane as I roll. It's not on my monitor. Like, I tried smashing it a few times with a hammer, and that did not seem to help. And then I took the Windex out. That also did not help. It's a little dot. You can also see it from the side, but it's harder. There it goes. It's moving around. You can kind of see it. It's a little dot that's suspended above the plane that's part of the plane model, unfortunately. Accidentally, because there shouldn't be something. It's not in the other two versions of the Spitfire. The Spitfire comes in a version that has floats and a version that has, that's just, I don't know. It's the same as this, but not the Kamikaze version. But this one has a little dot above it. And I'm like, they must have fixed that. That's why they had a download. Come on. But nope, they didn't fix it. It's not a, and I'm like, well, if they didn't fix it, it's going to ruin anything. It's not going to ruin anything. But it'd be nice if they fixed it. Okay, you see those, like, quarries and, like, you know, it's like a place where they're piling up maybe cement. But it looks nice, you know. It looks like a nice, this is like the outskirts. How far are we? We're basically that far from the city. What there aren't, you're not going to find is a lot of tall buildings. It's like, unlike a lot of cities that has a financial district where they put some skyscrapers up, and other Italian cities have tall buildings. But not Rome. Rome is a historic city. They don't need that. You know, I mean, they have plenty of you know, the same kind of activities that would go normally in a tall building. You see that little dot? Now that you see it, it's going to start to bother you. But the interior is amazing. I love how worn it is. It's got a few things. Do I need to turn on the air cooler, the oil cooler a little bit maybe? Get some of my oil cooling. I don't know. And oh, the control scheme, did they fix that? It kind of did. You still can't do the throttle from there. But now you can at least do the propeller and the mixture from there. Okay. Okay, now I've switched us to external tanks. What I want to know is, now that I've switched us to the external tank, is the fuel being used from the external tank? Yeah, I need it. Now, what it should do is, when it's zero, it's going to automatically drop that tank off, which is down here. It'll just disappear. You won't see anything cool. And then I have to switch to the main tank, or we'll run out of gas. But I don't know if we'll do that on this flight. But, you know, we're going to do a couple more fly rounds of Rome for the lay people. Also, gosh, I'm really hoping that I finally fixed my audio problems, which was related to, I think, a bad USB connection because they were intermittent. And they were definitely related to USB. So I'm getting another completely different 7-port USB hub. Maybe that will be better. Why is my trim way up there? Yeah, you need to, now it's really flying better now that I've got me, got the propeller and the mixture dialed back to a more reasonable range. It's not that hard to start up either. And the other thing is you can get, you can get updated, navigational here, but I think this one does not have that available. So you can open and close the canopy. What else do we have? By the way, smoke or something. I don't know. These are for tail wheel. That's flaps. Yeah, I'm not sure what else we got going on there. We're back to the Vatican. That's the Vatican. It'd probably be filled with people. And there's the steeple. Cool buildings kind of hide around behind here. No particular reason not stay low. What is the river that the Rome is on? The Tiber? No. No, it's not the Tiber. I forgot. Buildings being constructed. Right on. Deconstructed? I don't know. Pull some G's. See how well we can stick around just following the river. It's not that easy. This is a pretty tight turn river. That said, the Zero is well known to be one of the most maneuverable airplanes of its type. It was light. It did not have a lot of internal armor. It was considered rather easy to shoot down. Because a few bullets to one of the tanks would usually set it on fire, which was not true of the heavier American and European planes at the time. Some more cool sites of Rome. Presumably a very old building. Yeah, it's got some kind of modern looking buildings, that's for sure. And this area looks really like a fairly modern kind of financial district there. Maybe hotels, some kind of arena. That's a cool looking area. Probably a hotel there, I'm thinking. Okay, so yeah, so south of the city, it looks like is where kind of the hotels and the modern part of the city is. And then you go north, we're heading north now, and that's where it gets historical. So that's probably, look how, you know, it's kind of far off, but that's where kind of the taller buildings would be, the more modern buildings. That's kind of true in European cities. All right, well, I think I've taken out this another kind of cool building here. I think I've kind of worn the possibilities of Rome out, unless anybody has something specific they want to see. How you guys doing on YouTube, by the way? By the way, if people coming late, my past couple of streams, I had some bad audio issues. So the game audio did not have a problem. The audio coming from, this looks like that's in the station there. The audio coming from, and there's a pyramid, nice. The audio coming from my mixer was had dropouts, terrible dropouts. It was unlistenable. And back to the Circus Maximus. Nice. Look at some of these ruins. All right, and then this is all, and that's the Colosseum again. Okay, so all this stuff here is where kind of like Colosseum, and then this is the hill with all the famous ruins, I think. Nice. And it's all fun. I'd just say, yeah. But it's history, you know. It probably takes a long time just to walk around this area. The Arch of Constantine. Okay. Arch of Constantine. More stuff. Okay, we've been flown around a bunch, because this is the main terminal again. It's your main terminal. Alright, we're going to land back at the place we took off from. And then maybe we'll do another quick mission. Just not in the Mitsubishi, not in this particular Zero, although I really enjoy flying it. But that's the part, I enjoy flying it, I also want to land it and see how it's quite easy to fly. And if I remember correctly, unlike most tail draggers, the brakes work quite well. Villa Ada. Okay, that's probably old. Yeah, we got some Jenkins coming up here. We'll be fine. Okay, this is where we took off. So we're going to come around, turn off, and we're going to come land. We're going to make a U-turn and land here. Right at this little airstrip. Plenty of room. Yeah, when you brake, it does not tend to want to flip you over on your forehead. So we're going to turn around, we're going to get engine down a bit, we're going to slow down a bit. We're going to lower the landing gear. Let me get to a reasonable low speed. That's what it looks like. We're flying over the runway. We're going to kind of make a left turn here. We're going to make a sharper right turn here. What is our speed? 180. Watching our speeds. When we look back, okay, that's what we should see. So we're gonna bring the flaps down and make a sharp turn, bring our speed way down. Then I'm gonna bring the landing gear down. And we're gonna bring our sims with a nice, reasonably nice line up there. Gear down, flaps to full, 60%. Engines down to an idle. This is what it looks like from here. Oops, that's what it looks like from here. Kind of a controlled crash to the ground. We're moderately well controlled, smashing into the ground. At the last minute, you decide to not actually smash. Just kind of be all gentle about it. Well, we're a little fast. That's okay. Whoop. And then you can just smash. Flaps up will help bring the back of the plane down. And again, we can just kind of smash the brakes, and it doesn't seem to want to do anything too bad. So this is where we took off from, right there, as a matter of fact. Canopy open. I need air. Give me a second. Give me a second. It's fine. It's fine. It's just huffing and puffing. My computer, a little smoke coming out of the back there, but it'll be fine. It's not going to crash. I've never seen it crash when it does this. I willed it to not crash. Okay, and there's the canopy open. You can see I'm a Japanese. Oh, that's what they changed. That's the, that's a Japanese kamikaze pilot outfit. I don't think they had that last time. That's kind of controversial. That's what they would have actually taken off with in order to, under a first and last mission. And, you know, honestly, that's pretty brutal to think about. They wouldn't have had guns mounted on the plane or anything. Just a big bomb in the front, which they put, effectively, in the engine compartment, in front, between the engine compartment and the passenger, and the kamikaze pilot. But this is what they call it. It comes in three versions. There's a version with floats, there's the regular version, and then this is the kamikaze version. So specifically, what's different is the pilot is an actual recreation of a World War II kamikaze pilot. They would have been shaven head, and they would have wore that scarf. It was kind of almost a religious movement. So I love the history, but man, the idea of training pilots to go on one flight and be human bombs, you know, oof. That's what we look like. I just like to admire the plane. We didn't use all the, what happens is, if you use let me do this first. So that we don't stall out, I'm going to switch over to all tanks from external. Let's go to main. Okay. And I'm going to simulate what would happen if you didn't have any. It's not that dramatic. But if we manage to use up all the fuel in the external tank to zero, it does go away. You can see it's gone there now. So if you're in flight and that happens, it will disappear, which is kind of cool because it's like nice to see the plane without that drop tank. But that would have been realistic to have a drop tank. All right, let's turn it off. Now, turning it off is pretty simple. There's a couple ways you want to do it. I think the main way you're going to do it is by shutting your fuel valve off and then turning off your magnetos. Maybe the other way around, though. I'm not 100% sure. Boy, somebody was flying this new F5 today, and man, they made it look great. Oh, we can turn mixture to cut. Yeah, these are working now. So they fixed the controls. At least they fixed the controls. Is parking brake off or on? Now it's on. That's the other thing that's tricky to operate that. Okay, landing switch off, navigation. We don't need the dome light. We don't need panel lights. We're going to turn off the alternator and the battery master. Thus, leaving all the instruments cold. I thought that these planes would have that upgraded navigation unit, which they had a button right here for, but maybe the Kamikaze ones don't. Okay, so the Kamikaze, I'm just checking out the controls here. And everything that's over here, I don't think there's too much. Tailwheel lock, which I never know what to do with. That's flaps, and this is landing gear. It was kind of manually actuated. That doesn't really go anywhere, but anyway. And that's the plane. Oh, yeah, so when you turn off, the pilot leaves. Okay, that's fine. All right. Well, it is up to almost the 45-minute mark. So rather than trying to start another mission and going late in my Friday stream, is that a piano in the background? Thank you. By the way, thank you for coming over. By the, it's first, some, I have some question backlog on YouTube. Thank you for coming by. It is Microsoft Flight Sim 2020 with the new, with a couple playing, brand new plane that came in. It does look really good. It is a piano. I have a piano in the background and a synthesizer and another synthesizer. And then every other day, today I'll be playing guitar, but every other day I bring actually guitar on my piano right here in front of my desk, my workstation here. And I play piano right here. But today is a guitar day, so instead I'm going to bring my guitar right here. In fact, we're going to do that in about 5 minutes. There's because my thing is every day we split the stream into two parts. Part one is a Microsoft Flight Simulator mission, as you can see here in some, typically a vintage plane would be typical like this, a vintage warplane over a European city, and today this was Rome, if you want to check it out. And then a live performance. I love that air, that propeller too, how that's textured, like that wood texture. Good job there, because it would have been made out of wood. Again, and I alternate between guitar performance and piano performance. Yesterday was piano, so today's gonna be guitar. But I do want to take a short break to bring my guitar in and get some things plugged in. It's literally going to take 5 minutes or less. And then we'll be do the music part. I'm just going to dig, do it on the guitar and maybe sing a few songs. So stick around for that. Oh, okay. Welcome back. Just took a couple minutes because I'm basically just strapping the guitar on here. First, before we play the guitar, I'd like to talk about it just a little bit. Talk about, I have 16 guitars currently in the collection, a couple of which need a little work before I can really play them. Most of which are in excellent shape, but, you know, things happen, need a little soldering, replacements, happens all the time. Including my bass and a 12-string and a 6-string acoustic and some other kind of weird guitars and a bunch of Les Pauls. And then I have a Stratocaster and a Telecaster. And I got them both at the same time from the same series when they were producing the swirl pattern where each one is unique and completely it's dipped in a barrel water technique, of course. So I was able to pick these out from online catalog from the photos. They all look quite different, and these are the ones I like, the Strat and the Telecaster. I always wanted a Telecaster and a Stratocaster. It's got a great sound. That's a little loud, I think. Snappy. Especially from the bottom pickup, which is what you'll see here. Now, originally it comes with a lipstick pickup here, and I didn't like it at all. I thought it was muddy and nasty sounding and weak. So I ripped it out. This whole pick guard pulls out. There's room in the back there. You could just bought a new pickup and soldered it in. This is a lace humbucker. It sounds a lot different. It's still muted, but... it's not muddy. Bad boy. By the way, I hope you're enjoying the show today. As I like to say, I put on a hour and a half long improvised television show every single day, pretty much, which consists of it's a lot of a Carol Burnett show, you know. By the way, cheers, little Diet Coke. Except instead of Tim Conway, Lyle Waggoner, Harvey Korman, and the inimical Vicki Lawrence, you get none of those people, and you'll like it, okay? But you also don't get Carol Burnett, but you do get me. So it's a lot like the Carol Burnett show. I mean, do I take requests? Sometimes. Usually not. One time they were saying, can you play Creep by Radiohead? I'm like, hell yeah, I can play Creep by Radiohead. And then they also wanted the same stream. Somebody wanted to hear some Oasis, not Wonderwall, the other one. I'm like, sure. So sometimes if it's like it's a popular song that I really know, I will play it. But most of the time I will not. Camera and gray, and now you're here, and now you're away. I don't want this, remember that. I'll never forget you where you're at. Don't let the days go by, glycerine, glycerine. never alone. I'm alone all the time. Are you at one or do you lie? We live in a wheel where everyone feels right. Just when we rise, it's like strawberry field. If I treated you bad, you bruise my face. Couldn't love you anymore, you got a beautiful taste. Don't let the place go by. What could have been easier on you? I couldn't change, though I wanted to. What should have been easier by thing? Our old friends fear that you and me. Glycerine. Needed you more when I wanted us less. Could not kiss, just regress. It might just be you're simple and changing. That's just fine, that's just one of my names. Don't let the days roll by. What should have been easier on you? Glycerine. 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 You gotta know those. XV. I do like the Killers, though. Now, look at this camera here. What the heck is going on? That is not an effect I've commanded. Give me a second here. Look, see this? What is that about? Give me one second. I'm going to try deactivating and activating. Deactivate. Give me a second. Now, activate. Is it better? What is going on? Hold on one second. Configure video. Default. Does that make a difference? No, it's just messed up. Okay, here we go. Device default. Okay, well, that changed things. That's wrong. Hold on. Weird. Okay, let me just, hold on. It's weird that it won't, okay, stream cam proper. I'm going to fix this, but it'll just take a second here. Custom. Yeah, transform, reset. But yeah, it's still doing that slow thing there. I don't think I'll be able to fix that until I reboot. I'm not going to reboot. But it's a fun effect. We're going to have to live with that. We're going to live with that one. What the hell? Why not? I do like the Killers. People are asking about it. And I got this thing. It's a new thing. I've been trying to do a lot of improvements to my technology. One of them is this four scene switcher in OBS. Yeah, I remember Carol Burnett did tug her ear, but I unfortunately am wearing headphones, which you did not have to do, or I would do it. You know, she did. I loved the Carol Burnett show when I was a kid, man. See this? How it's like giving me about 10 frames per second. I think it might be an issue that my USB port thing is not doing well because I think it's plugged into that, and I'm not sure about that. So I'm getting a new one delivered in a couple of days, and we'll have to see if that improves it. The other cameras are fine. I've got three cameras, and that also seems like a lot, you know. And by the way, cheers, Lauren Diet Coke. Why not? Okay, here's the song I really like to do. Did my best to notice when the call came down the line, up to the platform of surrender. I was brought, but I was kind. Sometimes I get nervous when I see an open door. Close your eyes, bring your heart. Cut the cord. Are we human? Or are we dancer? My sign is vital. My hands are cold. And I'm on my knees looking for the answer. Are we human?
Pay my respects to grace and virtue. Send my condolences to good. Give my regards to faith and romance. They always did the best they could. So long to devotion. You taught me everything I know. Wave goodbye, wish me well. You gotta let me go. Are we human? Dancer, my sun is vital. My hands are cold, and I'm on my knees looking for the answer. Are we human? Are we dancer? Will your sister be alright when you dream of home tonight? There's no message we're receiving. Let me know, is your heart still beating? Are we human? Or are we dancer? My sign is vital. My hands are cold. And my long, my knees looking for the answer. Are we human?
Wow, I like singing that song. What else are we gonna sing? What else I like to sing? No one else. My still thing work. I gotta check my audio here. Seems to be working. Boy, I had struggling 2 days with dropouts in audio, and I think it's clean today, but it's just a poor USB thing that's going bad.
No one knows what it's like being the bad man. To be the bad man behind blue eyes. No one knows what it's like. To be fated to telling only lies. But my dreams, my heart is empty as my conscience seems to be. Love is vengeance, it's never free. No one knows what it's like to feel these feelings like I do, and I blame you. Back as hard on their anger. None of my pain and woe will can't show through. But my dreams, they aren't as empty as my conscience seems to be. Hours. My love is vengeance that's never free. When my fist clenches, crack it open before I use it, lose my cool. When I smile, please tell me some bad news, or I laugh and act like a fool. And if I swallow anything evil, put your finger down my throat. If I shiver, please give me a blanket. Keep me warm, let me wear your coat. No one knows what it's like, me the madman, to be the sad man. Behind blue eyes.
Anyway, man, I love singing. I mean, it's a great song. It's all over the place. That song is all over the place. But it's the few songs you can do with Who that's acoustically appropriate. You can play out kind of on acoustic guitar, really. You could try a few others. There's not very many. Like the only Floyd song you can really do. Boy, that 8 frames a second effect. By the way, the camera was not doing that earlier. Everything's a surprise. There's always something weird and new it does. Also, it's not the white balance. I can't get it right. It's just my regular stream cam. I've used it before. Yeah, the difference is it's plugged into this port now. It's plugged into a different port, so I think that's the issue. But I will work that. I'll get that fixed for the next stream or two. There's always something that's going to go wrong, okay? Well, I had an interesting 5 viewers simultaneously at YouTube for a few seconds there, which just sounds like a small number, but you should know normal is 0. The normal number is 0. So 5 is an infinitely higher percentage, you know what I mean? But then they all went away, so bye, YouTubers. I don't know what that's about, you know? They weren't regulars, but I don't have any regulars. But YouTube is mainly about the people watching on VOD later on, anyway. Okay, we gotta keep, as long as I'm running the transitions, we gotta keep playing. Right, let me get some lyrics up here. What are we gonna get here? What should we get here? Here we go. Okay, I don't really need the lyrics for this, but you know, just in case. Walls are built up, stone by stone. Fields are divided one by one. And the terrain conductor says, take a break, driver eight, take a break. We've been on this shift too long. And the terrain conductor says, take a break, driver eight, take a break. We can't reach our destination, still ways away. I saw a treehouse on the outskirts of the farm. Power lines have floaties so the airplanes won't get snagged. Bells are ringing through the town again. Children look up, all they hear are sky blue bells ringing. And the terrain conductor says,
take a break, driver aid, driver aid, take a break. We can't reach our destination. We're still a ways away, but we're still a ways away, still a ways away. Way to shield, pay the heat. A way to put myself to sleep. A way to shield the hated heat. Way to put myself, my children asleep. We parted this song in the pain like that one. She is sending faith on the hotel crusade. Locomotive 8, Southern Crescent, hear the bells ring again. Feel to eat is looking in. And the touring conductor says, take a break, driver aid, driver aid, take a break. We've been on a shift too long. And the touring conductor says, take a break, driver aid, driver aid, take a break. We can't reach our destination. Still a ways away.
Yeah, no, I mean, there's no one left on YouTube. No one on YouTube. I don't know why it doesn't always update the number. It shows the maximum that were there. I don't know. There was, at one point, there was 21. That's very unusual with my YouTube Live. By the way, I just started YouTube Live co-streaming January 1st, so it's about six weeks of it. I don't expect it to show any interesting progress for the first 6 months of doing this. So I got 4.5 more months to where I can say, okay, is anything happening on YouTube? But already people are coming over, I think, to Twitch from YouTube, maybe vice versa. It's the same content, although on Twitch you might see ads, and on YouTube I'm not monetized, so no ads. But on that, it's the same content, and I have the chat window up, so I usually see it. So I don't know if people, a lot of my friends will not go on Twitch, but they all have YouTube accounts. It doesn't mean they're going to visit me on YouTube Live. Okay, we're going to do, I need lyrics for this too. We'll do a little Sixpence None the Richer. Goes like this. Kiss me out of the bearded party, night me beside the green dream. Okay. Boy, I really like to sing this a little higher. Sorry. Really, really want to do it. Sorry. It's just too low that way. It's really supposed to be done up here anyway. It's also easier to play up here. A little bit easier anyway. Kiss me out of the bearded barley, nightly beside the green, green grass. Swing, swing, swing the spinning step. You wear those shoes, I will wear that dress. Oh, kiss me beneath the milky twilight. Need me out on the moonlit floor. Lift your open hand.
track at the bend and make the butterflies dance till the moon sparkling. So kiss me. Kiss me down by the broken treehouse. Swing me upon its hanging tire. Swing, swing, swing the spinning step. We'll take the trail marked on your father's map. Whoa, 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 kiss me beneath the milky twilight. Meet me out on the moonlit floor. Lift your open hand. Strike up the band and make the fireflies dance. Silver moon sparkling. So kiss me. Kiss me. Kiss me.
Interesting how they play up here, but I don't know how loud this capo. Like this. Little tune up here in the midsection. Thank you. Well, it takes your, by the way, if you're enjoying today's show, I'll ask you one little thing that you could do for me. First of all, Diet Coke, enjoy. I ask you one little thing. Just sidle yourself up to the bar, order a fancy cocktail, not a beer or a well drink, okay? Not for me, for yourself, not for me, okay? Order a fancy cocktail and absolutely be sure to tip the wait staff generously. They have on average 7 kids, so that's a lot of mouths to feed, all right? So please, please tip generously, extra generously, please. I'm asking, I'm begging. That's all. You don't have to give me anything. If you're watching me on one of them YouTube VODs, remember to smash that like button until it's bloody, basically. And then if you're on Twitch, use your Prime sub, or whatever the hell that is. Just call Bezos and ask him what that's for. He won't know. All right, we sang this one the other day, 2 days ago, and it was scuffed audio, and I thought I did a good job. So we'll try it again. I probably won't do a good job because that's how that goes, you know. But I think the audio is unscuffed. I'm not 100% sure. My driver, which had a message yesterday, it said, "Oh, you have USB interruption issues." It's not giving that error message. So. And I did test streams yesterday to indicate that I think I solved the audio issues. Hey, we'll find out after today's stream. Hold on, what what is it? Hold on a second. Give me 1 second here. What is the bass chord here? G? Yeah, I think it's in G. I assume it's in G, by the way. I'm gonna have to assume it's in G. Hit it, ready, go. Rains when the days when the rain came. Down in the hollow. Playing a new game. Laughing and running, skipping and I'm jumping. In the mist and rolling, following. Hearts are thumping in you. A brown eyed girl. You, my brown eyed girl. You remember me. Whatever happened? Tuesdays are so slow. Going down to the old mine with a transistor radio. Standing in the sunlight laughing. Hiding behind a rainbow's wall. Slipping and a sliding. Rolling along the waterfall with you. A brown eyed girl. Girl, do you remember when we used to sing la 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 la. So hard to find my way. Now that I'm on my own, saw you just the other day. My, how you have grown. Cast my memory back there, Lord. Sometimes overcome thinking about making love in the green grass behind the stadium with you. A brown eyed girl. Do you remember when we used to sing la 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 la. So what about with this tuning out here?
She don't lie.
Cocaine. Diet Coke. Cheers. A couple more songs maybe in me. Maybe. Why not? By the way, tomorrow's stream will be a lot like today's stream, except with the piano in place of the guitar, and that's pretty much how it goes on a daily basis. What do we got here? Heavily foreshortened version of that song, you know what I mean? How much stairway to heaven do you really need? You know what I mean? That's enough. That gets the song point across. Cheers! Oh my God, it's the giant Diet Coke. What last I'm gonna sing right here? Last one. Don't even. Doesn't matter how many 400 gift subs, I don't care. I'm done with after this one. But I also enjoy singing the songs about hard to sing. I see a red door and I want it painted black. No colors anymore, I want them to turn black. I see the girls walk by dressed in their summer clothes. I have to turn my head until my darkness grows. I see a line of cars and they're all painted black. Oh, the flowers and my love both never to come back. I've seen people turn their heads and quickly look away. Like a newborn baby, it just happens every day. I look inside myself and see my heart is black. I see my red door, I must have it painted black. Maybe then I'll fade away and not have to face the facts. Or easy facing up when war or world is black. No more will my green sea go turn a deeper blue. I could not foresee this thing happening to you. If I look hard enough into the setting sun, my love will laugh at me before the morning comes. I see a red door and I want it painted black. No colors anymore, I want them to turn black. Painted black, black as a night, black as cold, black as all of my little painted up inside, even my sad person, painted black. What a painted black.
Sorry about ruining that song for everyone forever. But, you know, it had to be done. It had to be done, and I'm the one who had to do it. Now, you might think, Ken, you just started streaming. I'm an hour and a half in. I'm an hour and 36 minutes in. And I only do longer streams. I like to do 2-hour streams on the weekends when nobody's watching anyway. Weekdays, an hour and a half is a long stream, especially because I'm not just sitting here talking to chat. I got to perform. I got to play Flight Simulator. I got to do that. I got to pour the Diet Coke. I get the light. I got to fix the cameras. You know, I got to help me. But also, I got to play. You know, I got to perform. One more song. I always like to do this one. There we go. Whole lyrics, please. Thank you. What last song you have to live through, though? Yeah, my USB ports go down. I can see there's still a little noise, a little action here on some of these cameras, especially the main camera. I want to check one thing, see if my audio is messed up. Still says okay. Okay, the last song. There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun. And it's been the ruin of many a poor boy, and God unknown one. My mother was a tailor. She sewed my new blue jeans.
By far I was a gambling man down in New Orleans. Now the only thing a gambler needs is a suitcase and a trunk. And the only time he's satisfied is when he's on a drunk. Oh, mothers, tell your children not to do what I have done. Spend your lives sinning misery in the house of the rising sun. Well, I got 1 foot on the platform, the other foot on the train, and I'm going back to New Orleans to wear that ball and chain. Well, there is a house in New Orleans they call the Rising Sun. And it's been the ruin of many a poor boy. And God, I know I'm one. Hey, if you enjoyed today's stream, remember that tomorrow shall be another stream very similar to today. Although, and I don't know, we're going to go back to the Dune content at some point, but probably not till Sunday. I think Sunday, actually. Sunday we're going to do, maybe Sunday or Monday, it's a holiday. We're going to do more of the Dune content. We'll do part two of Dune content, which is actually pretty fun to watch, I think. And then, and I should get better at it next time. And then we'll have a piano stream tomorrow. That'll be fun. And I hopefully I'll be checking the audio on this stream to see if the audio worked. I'm even fixing my third camera. Who knows? You know, probably broke one of the other two, but that's okay. You know, that's just how things go. So we'll see you guys all on the next time. I really enjoyed today's stream, as I always do, because I just do things I would do normally on a daily basis anyway. So see you tomorrow.